We've pointed out quite a bit of the good that was in the recent COVID aid bill, but there's some that perhaps we haven't targeted or talked enough about, especially because if you hear about it, you're probably gonna hear about it from the right wing, who is losing their minds about this particular component of it. And that is that in the $1.9 trillion coronavirus stimulus bill, about $5 billion were provided that will go towards forgiving debts of minority farmers in an attempt to repair historical racist discrimination on the federal level. And that is enough for them to completely lose it. And so, sometimes in a pretty simple form, people like Todd Starnes tweeting, farmers of color, which he puts in quotation marks. Are they not farmers? Are they not of color? Which part of that do you have a problem with? Says gets $4 billion bailout to pay off their debt. White farmers get nothing. Well, they get the COVID aid since they're Americans. They presumably get that. But then he says it's reparations, but it's not. It's racism. Pay your bills, America. First of all, they didn't say that it's reparations.
Say, who says that?
Who said that? The right? But yeah, the white farmers got all of the rest of the aid in the bill. Oh, and also the history of inequitable transfer of funds to farmers, primarily only farmers who are white. So that's the tweet form. Maybe even worse is Brian Kilmeade immediately raced to bring on a white farmer, and this is what they had to say about it.
How shocked were you to find that the color of your skin would be working against you when it came to your job?
Well, it was pretty disappointing. I thought all farmers would be treated equally.
Right here, I guess it's a form of reparations. Were, in your estimation, minority farmers being discriminated against?
Yes. Well, I'm not a racist person to start off with, but I don't think it's... I've worked all my life and worked very hard and to get where I'm at, and I didn't get no breaks like that. And I don't think that they should get breaks like that, not saying they don't deserve it, not to release or, you know, just to wipe out their debt. Well, y'all debt free, that's not right.
Okay. To his credit, I guess, when asked if they're discriminated against, he started by saying yes, and then immediately turned to, I'm not racist. But JR, Kilmeade asked a great question. He said, can you imagine what it would be like, how shocking it would be like for your skin color to work against you at your job? It's I mean, crazy. How could anyone imagine something like that, JR?
We can't imagine it. And I'm gonna go back to what I said earlier. And by the way, this isn't applied to Brian Kilmeade and people like him, because he knows the advantages that America gives to certain folks historically. So he's just playing a role. But imagine the horror. Imagine if there's an institutional, systematic way that you keep certain people from having opportunities in this country that they built. That'd be crazy, huh? Based off of your name, skin tone, where you're from. Your previous jobs, any of that stuff, anything about you. First off, primarily your name. We've seen things like that. Imagine being rejected from a job because of just who you are. It happens so much. And then when people try to fix that, you know what they get pushback from? People saying, oh, bootstraps. When is this white farmer gonna pull himself up by his bootstraps? Why is he complaining about someone else's money? Hey, you didn't get the money, stop complaining. What do you want, a government handout? You're gonna keep sucking off the government teat? What's the matter with you? You freeloading welfare queens. It's way too much. Obvious a background to the way that things have always been done here to certain folks, to now claim that it's being like taken out on you. And who called it reparations again? Who's calling reparations? It's ridiculous. And so, by the way, reparations being paying folks back for building the country and not getting paid for it. In fact, getting murdered, separated, slaughtered over this. Yeah. That's what reparations would be. But you're upset about that. You know why? Because we want to forget the fact that we built this country based off of slavery and enslaving African folks that we dragged over here and helped build our country. That's what we're trying to avoid having any kind of memory of. We want to make sure that no one remembers that part. We do it with our school curriculum. We do it the way the books and we teach our children. And now we do it on a political level where we make sure we don't want to recognize anything that happened in this country because our founding fathers or above anything and everything. But right now, when finally something's being done to try and even the playing field, which this is by far not enough, to simply do anything to raise any part of who you've already suppressed this long, that's a problem now. Now we got discrimination. Now we have to imagine what it's like to be feeling it, living in a racist society. Welcome to America, bro.
Exactly. Well, go a little bit easy on him. I know that you want him to, you know, use his bootstraps, but he can't reach them because they're blocked by the hands of every former president. But anyway, who's lifting them up? But yeah, and look, I know from his point of view, he thinks, well, look, I didn't pass that legislation that benefited historically benefited white farmers. But that's why he is not the person that you bring on to talk about this. He has no understanding and seems like little curiosity understanding how white privilege or structural racism actually exists. Again, it doesn't require you as an individual to do it for it to be a problem. You can have not done anything specific, and yet the system is still effed up in a lot of different ways that need to be fixed. So what you could do is bring on someone who actually understands this stuff, has worked on it, has done research on these things, which we will quickly summarize. So black farmers in America have lost more than 12 million acres of farmland over the past century, mostly since the 1950s, a result of what agricultural experts and advocates for black farmers say is a combination of systemic racism, biased government policy, and social and business practices that have denied African Americans equitable access to markets. Discrimination started a century ago with a series of federal homestead acts that offered mainly white settlers deeply subsidized land. Since then, local US Department of Agriculture offices charged with distributing loans have frequently been found to deny black farmers access to credit and to ignore or delay loan applications. So whether that individual farmer thinks that he as a white farmer has been benefited, that was the official government policy for decades and decades and decades that gave them a leg up, provided easy, cheap access to land as well as credit. This is just trying, and it's not going to, as JR pointed out, actually fix the inequity. It is trying to put some of these farmers who have been so abused by the US government on something kind of within sight of equal footing. That's all it's doing. But you wouldn't know that from that segment on Fox, because they just brought on a white farmer to say, they're not being fair to me, I'm white, it's so tough to be white in America.
Because if you brought on someone who knew the situation, they may bring up the fact that all these facts you just broke down, with the 12 million acres of farmland being lost from black farmers, being denied loans just because of who they are, all these things that were happening to folks. If you actually have someone talk about it, then the people who are pushing all of this hate and misinformation would have to actually answer back and be like, Brian, are you okay with the fact that 12 million acres of farmland have been taken from black farmers, or that their loans applicants that have been denied or delayed just because of who they are? Are you okay with that? Because you're arguing on the side that's okay with that. They won't bring those things up because then they have to attach themselves to the reality of the negativity that has been perpetuated forever in this country. So as long as you don't tell the whole story, you can then have this outrage about the result of the problem. We don't have to talk about the first problem. Let's just get mad about the result. A small change. This is a tiny change. $5 billion is nothing from what they've taken from these farmers over all these years. Nothing. Nothing whatsoever. We're mad about that to make sure that nothing else happens their way in the future. And the reason, and you're going to go to this, almost cussed, you're going to go to this guy next, because it's people like this that they give everyone else the mindset to then feel it's okay to mistreat and abuse, and then after something happens, call them welfare queens for getting something.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.